You are a student, a faculty member, a scholar. You are invested in the world's most noble profession, scholarship. Your scholarship might involve discovery, or integration, or application. Or perhaps you are engaged in the scholarship of teaching and learning. You might be developing new pedagogical models or using large data sets to investigate youth activism or political extremism or the local food movement. Regardless of what you do, your work is important and it has the potential to change the world. You know this. I know this. So why are some of us tucking our scholarship away, hiding it from broader audiences, and locking it up behind paywalls? Is there not a better way? We know some of the reasons academics don't reach for broader audiences. We don't have time, we are not trained for it, and writing for audiences other than colleagues is not valued. And let's face it, sometimes it's frowned upon. There is an increasing realization globally that research should make meaningful and positive contributions to society. But some of our traditions, like keeping our knowledge in inaccessible journals, constrains us. In recent years, though, we have seen a multitude of digital ways that academics use to share their scholarship. Many scholars today publish YouTube videos, write blog posts, and join Twitter chats. Is there an increasing desire, a yearning perhaps, to reach beyond the walls of the academy to have greater impact on society? Perhaps that is what compels some scholars to employ the tools available to them and broaden the reach of their work. Perhaps scholarly tweeting and blogging are a symptom of how scholarship is already changing. One of the ways that my research team and I mobilize our research is by developing whiteboard animation videos, such as this one. These videos combine images, sound, and animation. They are short and tell a story. They are also freely available and explain research results in simple terms. We have helped others to create their own videos and we have learned a lot through this experience. Two important lessons we have learned are the following. First, we learned that translating research for broad consumption is difficult. Researchers are not trained on how to do this effectively. Proper training involves a multidisciplinary way of thinking about research dissemination. For example, in such training, we might need to help people understand storytelling and digital cultures. Just to mention a couple of examples, we likely need to help people understand the role that keywords, algorithms, and communities play in research mobilization. Second, in helping others, we learned that our colleagues are very excited to see their work come alive in this manner. Though they are passionate for the research, they may not be as passionate about its translation and dissemination. Many do not have the expertise or the time to create these videos, yet some have institutional funding or grant funding that support these endeavors. The web is a beautiful and scary place. It's a place of paradoxes and tensions. But it's part of our daily reality, and instead of isolating ourselves to our closed journals and walled gardens, we should get out a little bit more. But we should do so with recognition of the challenges that we and our colleagues may face online. Whether it's through whiteboard animations or through a different activity, our societies will thank us for it.